bring back aspects of the small island. Number one. Number two, expand them.
President Yoweri Museveni's statement reinforces the government's commitment to streamline operations and reduce wastage. The remarks come as a critical response to ongoing discussions about improving public sector performance. Museveni made the remarks on Tuesday while addressing a meeting at State House Entebbe, with an emphasis on enhancing the efficiency and effectiveness of public service delivery. The president underscored the necessity of rationalization as a fundamental strategy for optimal resource allocation within government structures.
So, bring back, expand. But number three, diversify.
In attendance were key parliamentary committee leaders including Amos Kankunda, MP Rampara, Chair of Finance, Planning and Economic Development, Ikojo John Bosco, MP Bukedia, Chair of the National Economy, Linda Uma, Woman MP Lira, Chair of Agriculture, plus John Aliek, Woman MP Kole, Chairperson of Eco Opportunities. Other government officials who attended the meeting included the Prime Minister Robina Nabanja, the Attorney General Chiriowa Chiwanuka, and various government ministry coordinators. Hoima City authorities will engage the subcontractors of Hoima Stadium to resolve various issues raised by residents and leaders. Last week, during the Hoima East Division Council meeting, leaders raised concerns of reckless driving by the contractors. They said the drivers should cover their soil loads and avoid overspeeding while in overpopulated areas. The mayor of Hoima City, Brian Kaboyo, said the main contractor, Suma Construction Company, subcontracted three local companies.
We are going to engage them. Three subcontractors, Ugandan companies, Zahanu, Reza Loko Zirimu. So we need to harmonize with them, Kubagambira, Evitaka, Kubirubasa. Kikaro Mutapa na Kugamaka and Joana Kubasira Kula, Skada Project T, Omuliba Guna Kuangu, Atibara Batidanka, Kurumono Kurora, Ndima, Giteire Mukurubata Ampora, Omulima Guakora, Kukanga, Obo Kuali Tak.
Kaboyo also asked the local communities to be patient, citing the tight schedule that the contractors are working under. In June, the government, through the Ministry of Education and Sports, signed a contract with MS Suma, a Turkish company, to construct a 20,000-seater Hoima multipurpose stadium ahead of the 2027 Africa Cup of Nations. Intense monsoon rains and floods in India's southern states have killed at least 25 people, with thousands rescued and taken to relief camps. At least 16 people have been killed in Telangana state and 9 in neighboring Andhra Pradesh in the past 2 days. Around 3,800 people have been rescued in Telangana and moved to relief camps. India's Air Force said it had flown more than 200 rescue officers and 30 tons of emergency aid to both states. Rains cause widespread destruction every year, but experts say climate change is shifting weather patterns and increasing the number of extreme weather events. Last week, at least 28 people were killed over 3 days in the western state of Gujarat. The northeastern state of Tripura was also hit by floods and landslides in August, with more than 20 people killed. In neighboring Bangladesh, downriver from India, floods killed at least 40 people over the same period, with nearly 300,000 residents taking refuge in emergency shelters.